The police commissioner admits it's become more challenging for officers on the front line as the service tries to bolster its ranks and fill rosters. Katerina Carroll today has addressed urgent matters raised in Parliament over the safety of the men and women in blue.
Queensland police have stared down warring bikies and heightened terrorism threats, and now a youth crime wave.
Post-COVID, the behaviour of youth has changed. There's more DV, there's more mental health.
Police officers are only human. They can only take so much. They're placed in critical situations all the time now.
The commissioner today responding to media reports raised in Parliament suggesting officers are spread too thin and increasingly feeling like sitting ducks on the streets.
These offenders wouldn't give a second thought to driving onto the footpath and striking a police officer. They have no fear of the law.
Is policing more dangerous now than it was a few years ago?
I think policing is more challenging, definitely. The role of policing has substantially changed, quite frank about this.
The minister and commissioner both playing down other concerns that QPS rosters are harder to fill because of shortages.
How bad are rostering issues on the Gold Coast and around the southeast?
It's interesting because I just got some data as a result of that. There's less people on sick leave than was in 2022. So there have been challenges, and we've been quite frank about that, but the figures are improving.
The union suggesting the need for longer shifts and bigger breaks between them to manage fatigue.
And especially with the front line, who are going to major and serious incidents each and every day and not knowing what will confront them.
Josh Bavis joins us live in studio now. Josh, there are murmurs of a no-confidence vote in the police commissioner among the ranks.
Well, Melissa and Andrew, Nine News has been told that there are some who have moved within stations, notably on the Gold Coast. But for a motion of no-confidence to proceed against the commissioner, they would really need the backing of the police union. I spoke to the union late this afternoon and they say not one of their members are moving against Katerina Carroll. Her term is up for renewal in July, and the commissioner has a strong record at the G20, the Commonwealth Games. Andrew and Melissa, it's clear that some might not be happy, but she does have the backing of the government and the unions.
Thanks, Josh.